Yo, what up? Welcome back to the channel. Doing a J-Day race at Dozer Memorial. This is May 28th, 2023. Moto 2 for senior, A senior. Track was more woodsy style today. A lot of rocks in the start, a lot of rocks everywhere. It was a real bony track. A lot of roots too. I struggled today. But we'll do a lap with me in this J-Day race. So doing the start, I stalled my first moto and came from dead last to 10th. I don't even know how many people were in the race, but I got 10th first moto. And in this moto, I got 9th. I got a decent jump for the start for me. This is where I wanna be. That's JD in front of me. Whoa, someone just went by me like crazy. But anyway, I thought I was doing well. I let spots like this slip by. I don't know why, but you went up that start stretch to this right-hander. It was like a two lanes. I was on the right where there was nobody. Everybody went left, and I kind of see why now, because like all these people could get by me right here. This left-hander had a real long slick root right here. See that right there, that white stick? You don't want to plant your front wheel on that. A lot of whoops here, I guess I would say. Developing late in the day. This is the second moto, so a real dry track today too. This nice sandy section, I like this section, hopping up this a little bit. Just trying to go up the middle here. This is the main preferred line. I like this. Taking this left on the gradual uphill. A lot of vines, like viney kind of terrain. Taking this slight right, straight away with some acceleration bumps then to this right-hander. These were pretty big holes right there. Going up this hill, taking a right, you can see all the white roots there. It's crazy, like there was a lot of roots. This track was on a mission, and its mission today was to claim people. It took a lot of people out. We had a 2-hour delay because the ambulances were all out. That sucked. So pretty, I think it started the delay, and then the races started back at like 3:30, something like that. Anyway, this is kind of like a nice downhill going to a left-right at the bottom of the hill. Then you can kind of get on it right here. This was a section I was struggling. I don't know why. I couldn't find balance going up that little mound. Big roots there. I just decided to wheelie over them, just get the front wheel over them. It worked out for me. Then you had this monster hill with these big rocks coming out of the face, and just gradually going. So big rollers. This right-hander, couldn't find any place to bite on that right-hander. I had to push off something, it was weird. I gotta practice on my side tire bite so I can like take flat track corners. Going up this hill, this was this was just a generic trail riding kind of area, one line stuff really. A lot of roots again, keep repeating myself. Then going up this way, this was a preferred line that I wanted to take. There was some roots right there, it was a big one. I think that was the best line without, on the left there was a lot of like ledge and stuff coming out. So that was the smoothest line, how about that? Going down this, straight, and then we make our way onto the cart roads. These cart roads were slippery as hell because it was hard like concrete. A lot of big like basketball sized boulders in the middle of the trail, and just cranking on it, trying not to hit those big rocks. And this is going into a right-hander. I almost missed that turn like 3 times. This left-hander, this is the same as last year's track, the same side section where the trails are. Kind of one line. Nothing crazy here. I was trying two lines at the end here. You can go to the left or the right, and it just shot you out different right here. But then you go up this gradual hill. It was a plateau kind of deal. Then back down and then rake this left-hander, and there's like a rhythm section, a double, and then into this right-hander. Real choppy today, real dry, hot, 89, 90 degrees or something. It was overall a good day. I finished 9th in this moto, so that's not bad for me. down this big downhill. Then we get into the check station coming up. It's left and right, left again. And you have this nice double or triple if you had the balls to hit it. It looks cool when someone hits it, but I was only doubling it. And yeah, it still felt cool. Then you straight drag race to the extreme. This is about one lap in, but right after the extreme, you go back into the woods. So yeah, this is, I'm getting better at the extreme sections, I think. I'm not worried about it as much, trying to get on it. So this is where the first turn went into. So now that was one lap. Anyway, overall, the whole day was good. Like I said, we had a 2-hour delay, so we got out of there at like 7 o'clock at night. A lot of people got taken down. I know JD, one of our buddies, our guys that we ride with, he broke his leg, which sucks. Wish him a speedy recovery on that. And a bunch of like kids I saw, like younger, like youth, ended up hitting like the starting log and flying over it. They had a big log facing you straight on the left at the start, which was kind of stupid, but they ended up moving it and putting dirt on it. Too many people clipped it. So I don't know what happened here in the race. I just randomly let people pass me. I gotta stop doing that because I was in probably seventh. I gave up two places to people that weren't junior B. I think the top three junior B's got me, and that's just how it is. They're fast, they're young, they know these trails, I guess. But anyway, I've been working on like trying to mountain bike the trails if I can before the race. That seems to help me just to get an idea of line choice. But once the race starts, you really gotta make your decisions on the go. Well, like and subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching again. And yeah, like, I let this moto go. This is a full 30 minute moto. And yeah, I got 10th overall today. Ninth overall today, I think. Anyway, like and subscribe again. And I'll catch you at the next. Later.